The universe can be defined as anything that is, was, or ever will be. So far as we know, it encompasses everything. And through that, as a whole, remains the most mysterious phenomenon we can ever know. It may even be that we are destined to never have a complete understanding of it. It's simply too hard, and the experiments needed to glean more information become impossible to perform. We are just too small in the face of the great expanse around us. But there is hope that at least some of the mysteries of the universe may yet be solved. So here are 10 mystery-filled aspects of the lifetime of the universe that in time, just maybe, we might be able to answer. Number 10. Time Zero, the birth of the universe. We live in a universe that exhibits a number of lines of evidence that point squarely to the Big Bang, the start of it all, and the commencement of all time, matter, distance, and everything within the universe. Throughout, there have been challenges to the Big Bang model, and new ones continue to appear, but none really hold up in the face of observational evidence ranging from the discovery of the cosmic microwave background radiation, the afterglow of the Big Bang, to the expansion of the universe itself many decades ago. Any alternative models must account for this mounting evidence. If not a Big Bang, then what created these attributes of our universe? But the Big Bang is not really a seamless idea either. The biggest reason for that is that, while you can trace it back to a few hundred million years after the event, it all becomes opaque, and we simply can't see further back in time than this brick wall. But we can gather clues in a completely different observational way, that of the particle accelerator. Mega machine accelerators, such as the Large Hadron Collider, can give us insights on the creation of particles that would have been a part of the Big Bang process so long ago, and allow us to get at least some clues as to what was going on behind the Great Brick Wall. What we do know is that the earliest moments of the universe were hot and dense, far more than anywhere in the universe today. That means a lot of particle collisions, and honestly, a complete mess of changing energies and transformations between particle types into other particle types. Chaos. It's hard to make sense out of the ultimate chaos that has ever occurred in our universe, and that's the challenge scientists face. But within this are some of the most fundamental mysteries of all. What set this whole process off? Unknown. From what we can tell, there had to be slightly more matter in the universe than antimatter, but there seems to have had to be an imbalance between the two. What caused that? When and how did dark matter first appear in the universe? A total unknown. And no doubt, the more we unravel, if we ever truly unravel all of it, it seems likely that new mysteries will appear. Number 9. 10 to the negative 36 seconds. Inflation. While just why the Big Bang happened and what, if anything, was before it remains serious mysteries within cosmology, there are some hints. As Stephen Hawking once pointed out, pondering what might have been before the Big Bang is pointless because it's also the beginning point of time as we know it. We think of everything in terms of causality. One thing leads to the next, giving us a perception of time moving forward. But in reality, that's an inherent property of the universe. It does not speak to what, if anything, is before it or outside it. Naturally, this has led to interesting ideas being advanced, not the least of which is the question of Roger Penrose's cyclic Big Bangs, where this is just one iteration of a perhaps infinite number of Big Bangs and universes, or Neil Turok's two-sided universe, reaching in opposite directions out of the Big Bang, one in forward, the other perhaps in reverse. We may never know the answers to these questions, because they may never be testable, but one aspect of the Big Bang represents a truly weird mystery, that of cosmic inflation. In a nutshell, there appears to have been a time period very early in the Big Bang, where the universe expanded at a rate much faster than it does at any other period. Think of it like this. You can have a bomb sitting in a storage facility. It has the capacity to explode, but chances are it's not going to unless the exact conditions needed for it to detonate are satisfied. The universe may work this way. Its expansion can be predicted, and at a certain rate, which is accelerating, another mystery. But under special circumstances such as those present in the earliest moments of the universe, it can behave differently. There is evidence for this in the uniformity of temperature of the cosmic microwave background radiation. For it to be as homogeneous as it is, all of it had to be in relative close proximity before inflation. But for us to see it as it is today, inflation must have happened. At the same time, though, inflation isn't settled, and there are other models. This is really a case where there are simply still too many mysteries cumulatively confounding attempts at truly understanding inflation, and if it happened at all. Number 8, 20 minutes to 100 million years, matter and the first stars. All material that we interact with in our lives is ultimately matter. Barring going to space, and even then you must take some of it with you, we will spend our entire lives bathed in an atmosphere made up entirely of atoms. From our life-giving water, H2O, to the materials that make up our cell phones, it all comes down to the members of the periodic table. And this process of the creation of matter began in the early universe, Big Bang nucleosynthesis. And while only the simplest atoms were first synthesized, through the action of stars, the universe became populated with the materials that make up everything, including ourselves. Within a few millionths of a second, the soup of subatomic particles created in the Big Bang formed protons and neutrons as it cooled and expanded. This was the advent of hydrogen, followed shortly after by a few heavier elements. Most of this happened only within the first 20 minutes of the life of the universe, before cooling down too much. The interesting part of this, however, is the abundance of helium that was formed during this time. It put serious constraints on just how the Big Bang could have unfolded, or we'd have more helium than we actually do. Interestingly, abundances measured in pristine areas of the universe line up perfectly with the Big Bang model. And this would have paved the way for the formation of the first stars in the universe, known as Population 3 stars. We have yet to directly observe a star like this. You're looking back to the earliest days of galaxies. But they very likely existed, and their supernovas were responsible for populating the universe with elements heavier than lithium, hydrogen, and helium, creating the building blocks for eventual planets. But there are still many questions within the topic of the formation of stars. And again, we have yet to directly see them, though there are hints, and within this leaves another open question. Just when was it possible for the first planets to form? Number 7, 10 to 17 million years, the first epoch of habitability. If you go with certain models that predict the absolute earliest time it was possible for stars to form, go supernova and populate at least some areas of the universe with heavier elements, you end up reaching back to a time where the entire universe was at a temperature that was habitable, regardless of the presence of a planet, if such things could exist that early, was near a star or not. The cosmic background radiation itself during this period was warm enough to allow for liquid water on most bodies in the universe. While it's unlikely for planets to have existed during this period, a mere 10 to 17 million years after the Big Bang, if they did, it's also possible for them to have spawned life unbelievably early in the history of the universe. More if certain conditions were present, such as a hydrogen envelope on those exoplanets, or heating through radioactive decay, that initial life might have survived far longer than the period where the CMB was at the right temperature. But the chances of such early life still existing now are very low. So that leaves us with a rather odd mystery. Was there an earlier epoch of life in the universe? And if there was, it's very unlikely that any indications of it still survive. And it could be an unanswered question forever. Number 6, 900 million years, the second epoch of habitability. Regardless of an earlier epoch of habitability in the universe, we know for a fact that there has been a second. We are a part of that, with life on Earth having arisen over 3.8 billion years ago. But this later epoch of habitability extends much further back in time. Currently, the oldest known planet in the Milky Way, known as the Methuselah or Genesis planet, comes in at about 12.7 billion years old. While it's not Earth-like, it's a gas giant about 2.5 times the mass of Jupiter, and it orbits a pulsar and a white dwarf binary system, it shows that planets began appearing very early in the history of the universe. This could mean that Earth-like planets may have existed billions of years before Earth formed, and ostensibly might have hosted life and civilizations that could be many times older than our own. This, of course, leads to one of the greatest mysteries of all, the Fermi paradox, and in that, given the age of the universe and the availability of planets, there should be evidence of alien civilizations everywhere, near and far. Yet we see no evidence of that. So, where is everyone? Number 5. 9.2 billion years, the coming age of Earth. One of the more popular solutions to the Fermi paradox is that for all the age of the universe, intelligent life hasn't really been possible until now due to various factors. In other words, we are simply early in the game, and there are few others out there right now. What goes with this is the notion that as the universe ages further, we should see an intelligence explosion, where an increasing number of technological civilizations arise and join us. But that's just speculative. It may be that we are either so rare, though never likely to be alone, that we will never contact or verify the existence of alien life. This opens a whole can of mysteries that we have yet to confront. Today, we expect, perhaps half-heartedly, to detect alien life. A majority of people believe it's out there somewhere, and some believe it's here, but the proof is lacking. But say after another 10,000 years, we still have found nothing. Then we have to confront the mystery of why we're here. And apparently, no one else is. One instance of intelligence in a universe so vast that we can only ever see a small part of it, the observable universe. The rest is uselessly disconnected from what one can only presume is the entire point of its existence. We are, after all, the universe observing itself. Number 4. Distant future stars that no one has seen. One interesting mystery in astrophysics lies in the exercise of envisioning the future of the universe and what becomes possible only through age. A question here is if there will someday be entire classes of stars that do not currently exist in the universe, based on what we know of physics, and then run stellar physics and fast forward to see what happens. The reason this is thought to be possible is that the universe is simply too young for certain types of stars to have come into being. It's been this way before. There was a time in the universe's history where stars like the Sun couldn't yet exist, due to a lack of raw materials that produce the chemical makeup they have. One such theoretical future star is that of a blue dwarf. As it stands right now, the most common type of star in the universe are the red dwarfs, tiny reddened cool stars that are set to live for trillions of years, far longer than the Sun. But when the red dwarfs do begin to reach their ends and have consumed much of their hydrogen fuel, like other classes of star, they must change. A star like the Sun will simply change its equilibrium and become a red giant, but not so for the red dwarfs. Rather than expanding, very small red dwarfs about a quarter of the mass of the Sun or less end up becoming hotter on their surfaces and become bluer, at least in a sense. They won't actually become blue-colored stars, it's a matter of the light they emit. And most extreme of the simulations of these future stars creates a kind of blue-white former red dwarf. This only lasts for a time before these stars simply become stellar remnants, white dwarfs. And then they will go through a very long cooling stage, to eventually become yet another hypothetical object, a black dwarf. Essentially a cinder left over from where a star used to be. But this whole thing is dependent on our current models to be correct. And given that we have a partial understanding of the universe, until one of these objects appears in the universe, it may be a mystery for the entire run of humanity, because it's unlikely we will last long enough to actually observe one of these hypothetical stars. Number 3. The Big Freeze. In the history of cosmology, there have been a number of theories about what happens at the end of the universe, or if it even has an end. Over time, however, a consensus has developed based on observation that one aspect of the universe that we know exists will come to define what happens in the future. It's the expansion of the universe, and observation strongly suggests that it will continue to expand forever. This means that the universe overall will continue to cool through its process of expansion until ultimately it becomes impossible for the universe to sustain life. And the expansion of the universe through the action of dark energy is accelerating. Eventually, the cold and the dark take over, where redshift becomes so stretched that light from other areas in the universe will be stretched to undetectable wavelengths. Star formation stops due to a lack of hydrogen needed for them to coalesce. Eventually, all that are left are the red dwarfs, and they begin to blink out. So in this vision of the practical end of the universe, at least as we know it, the mystery is in if anyone out there, ourselves included, could somehow devise ways to survive it, or if advanced science will let them create a new universe to escape to. And there's also the question of late life in the universe under these conditions. They could do very little cosmology under a completely black sky, and just before their extinction, they might realize that they have little understanding of the universe, and what once was will forever be a mystery to them. Number 2, proton decay. One of the biggest mysteries in particle physics is the question of whether the proton is truly stable or will in the very far future decay. As best as we can tell, the proton seems to be the very definition of stable. But in the 1960s, it was suggested that over immeasurable amounts of time, the proton might decay into two light subatomic particles, a pion and a positron. One of the uncertainties here involves things like quantum tunneling, which may be a mechanism for the decay to happen. But within a more complete understanding of quantum mechanics and gravity, it's anyone's guess whether the major components of matter itself will, in the very far future, begin to dissolve. This will be a strange time for the universe indeed, where matter as we know it is beginning to disappear, leaving in its wake a soup of subatomic particles existing in a very cold universe, forever. And the nature of the universe is a big bang, a short age of stars and galaxies, and an end that is an infinity of almost nothing. Number 1. Iron stars and evaporating black holes. One of the last objects in the universe will be the black holes. Stellar remnants will most likely make their way to supermassive black holes, and much of the universe will even be devoid of cinders. But even the black holes themselves aren't permanent, but will slowly evaporate over enormous amounts of time through Hawking radiation. But if the proton does not decay, there is one last option for objects in the universe, iron stars, that may form in the distant far future through quantum tunneling, on the level of 10 to the power of 1500 years. If these remnants ever exist, their ultimate fate may be another round of black holes, which will then also evaporate, and other than the infinitely existing soup of subatomic particles not doing much of anything, the universe will have ended and become a remnant in itself, subject only to infinite time. Thanks for listening. I'm futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier. Be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.